Okay, so last night the CW aired Green Arrow and Canaries, which is the 9th episode of the 8th and final season of Arrow, and it is a backdoor pilot for a potential spinoff. So, that in mind, let's talk about Green Arrow and the Canaries. Jeez. Wish I had a graphic. Let's talk about, you know. So, I guess I gotta sort of start at the beginning. Oliver was washed away on an island not that far. Beginning of this. In season 7, we started having these flash forwards. I mean, the show is known for its flash backs. And now we got flash forwards that was a shock when it was there's this guy looking for someone to go to the NU. Which, if it was a flashback, it looks like all messed up. And if it was a flashback, we're like, what? And this is William, the son of Oliver Queen, and he's looking for Roy, which is older Roy. And that's where these flash forwards started. And this flash forwards kind of started a, you know, Arrow is ending, so they're going to spin off with these future characters, which is the daughter of Oliver Queen and Felicity Smoke, and the Smoke, the son of Oliver Queen and someone who I forgot, and those characters in the future. Well, they weren't received so well, so they used Crisis as a way to reboot the entire future. And, so now we have a new future, and this new future, in the original future, Mia, the daughter, she was Black Star. She was a cage fighter. She, you know, and William never knew she existed. And William is now gay. This is fine. You know, and they got sent back to the past. And they had to meet their father. But what I never got is why they were sent back to begin with, because they weren't really part of Crisis. Like, Mia was for a hot second, but then, like, they weren't really important. And by the time Crisis was over, history had been rewritten. So they're not even, you know, they weren't even in the past. One thing you need to know before I go is that, before I continue, I should say, is that John Diggle Jr., the son of John Diggle and Lila Michaels, was a villain in one storyline, in the original timeline. And he killed Zoe, which is Renee Ramirez's daughter. And now in this future, like, no one remembers. If you remember me mentioning Crisis, John Jones, the Martian Manhunter, was using his powers to bring back people's memories of, you know, before Crisis stuff. And that kind of feeds into this as well. So we start in 2040. Laurel is chasing, like, Laurel, from the way she talks, acts, and stories she tells, it's Earth 2 Laurel, which is confusing. She talks about how her Oliver died on the Gambit and was cheating on her with her sister. And that's the Earth 2 Laurel story. And then she became Black Siren after her father died. So, it's gotta be Earth 2 Laurel, right? So she's chasing Bianca Bertinelli. I've been thinking about this all morning, because I originally watched this morning at like 3:30 in the morning. I woke up, couldn't get back to sleep, You know, you did sometimes, you wake up in the middle of the night, you have to pee, and then you can't get back to sleep. That's the way it was. Luckily for me, it was 3:30 in the morning, which is close enough for me to be able to get up, get ready for work and stuff. So I decided to watch this, and I was going to do a review. I'm like, you know what? No, I don't feel like it. And then I was at work, I'm like, I started talking to myself about it. I'm like, you know, I need to do a review of this. So, Lisa, let's talk about. So, Laurel, Bianca Bernelli. I thought about this also. The actress they got to play Bianca Bertinelli is African-American. But, and they say she's Helena Bertinelli's daughter. Helena Bertinelli is Caucasian. So, what is that? I understand if she married an African-American man and they had a child, but she's a criminal, so. And I also thought of, oh, adoption, but she's a criminal! Helena Bertinelli is a criminal. She's killed people. She tried to kill her own father. For God's sake. It doesn't make any sense. And she's... I also heard, oh, that could be adult Sarah. That could work. But no, they had a Bianca Bertinelli, which doesn't make any sense. And then she's... they talk, at one point they talk with her cousins, and they're Caucasian, white. I'm like, okay. So it's confusing, you know? If she was a product of a mixed, you know, like a mixed couple, she would be mixed herself. Like she, if her dad was African American and her mom was white, she would be mixed, but she's a dark, dark skin. What do they call that? Nubian? I don't know, but dark, dark skin. And it's like, I just don't understand. Maybe they'll explain it if this gets picked up, but I just didn't get it. We find out that Mia is dating, at the beginning of this dating at least, JJ, John Dingle Jr. I'm going to refer to him as JJ from now on. She's dating JJ. And I actually watched the beginning of this with my son last night. Just the first 5 minutes. And it was funny because his name's William. And the, you know, Green Arrow's son is named William. And when he popped up on the screen, I went, William! He's like, yeah? I'm like, no, not you. His name is William. He's like, oh, okay. But yeah, it's like, she wakes up and they have this computer where it's like a keyboard right here, and there's little screen pops up, and it's like hologram and stuff, because it's the future. It's the future! And, excuse me. And it's just, it's weird. She's dating JJ. I thought that was an interesting choice. I'm like, okay, because she was dating Connor, which is his adopted brother. And this version of Connor seems to be a little more of a troublemaker than the other version. It's kind of like they've switched roles, but so far we haven't seen that Connor is a villain type. We also get that Dinah Drake, the Black Canary, she is in the future. And she says the day after Oliver's funeral, she woke up in the future. She doesn't know how she got there. Sarah found her, and she said she didn't want to leave. And I guess, I think Sarah is the reason that Laurel got there, I think. That's good. But yeah. So, they go to Mia for help, but Mia, for some reason, doesn't know who they are. I've seen some people confused, or at least a couple people. Well, if Dinah disappeared the day after the funeral, she probably wouldn't know who she is. The only problem with that is, in set photos, you know, promo images of Mia's at the funeral. And that, I thought, oh, so it's after this episode, and they go back for the funeral. And then she said, after the funeral, I'm like, okay. So does she just travel back for the funeral and come back here? The whole thing is going to be confusing, because there's people that are supposedly dead, and people that aren't technically, well, she's born, but it's confusing. And, it's confusing. When I explain the end to you, you'll be with me as to why, how, you know. So they go to talk to Mia. Mia doesn't know either of them. I understand Dinah, because she disappeared. But Laurel, unless Laurel had not, like, had just, like, taken off. Because they say that the Star City, at least, has been at peace since Crisis. So, no, you know. Since Crisis, the city has been at peace. So, you know, maybe they didn't need heroes. Black Canary or Canaries of any sort. Who knows? But she doesn't know either of them. And, well, so Laurel has this ring that Jean gave her that has that power. Touches Mia, she gets her memories back. Sees all the stuff, you know, JJ killing Zoe and all the stuff. And so she's conflicted now, because I should have mentioned this, JJ proposed to her, she's engaged to him, and so she's kind of conflicted with this now. I'm like, okay, this is going to be, you know, show the conflict. They barely show it. And I'm like, going towards the end, I'm like, okay, they can still build on the conflict. Is she, you know, still want to be with him, and she knows what he did, even though he didn't actually do it in this world. And then they flip it on its head with the, or this timeline, and they flip it on its head with the ending, which we'll get to. So, they're trying to, the reason that Laurel is there is that she's trying to stop Bianca Bertinelli from being killed, because when she gets killed, all hell breaks loose again. So, she enlists Dinah and Mia, and they bug the Bertinelli house of the cousins. She thinks something might be going on there. And it leads them to something's being moved, and a Deathstroke shows up. And automatically they point fingers at JJ. Except for Mia, but they point fingers. Laurel points her finger at JJ. And I'm like, if you think, okay, this didn't come true either, but my thought was, in this timeline, JJ and Connor are like the opposite. Almost. Because what was presented to us in the original timeline was that Connor was this wealthy guy who, you know, could get anywhere and had, you know, parties and stuff. And, well, now, JJ is in that position. And while JJ was the leader of a Deathstroke gang, and that's really bad, but Connor seems to be this troublemaker. Like, they mentioned he went to rehab. So my thought was, maybe it's Connor. But the reveal of who this is so stupid. I didn't even remember his name. That's one of the reasons why I rewatched it, because I couldn't remember his damn name. So, at the party, they talk to Bianca's ex-boyfriend. I forgot it again. Trevor, I should have remembered. That's my mom's cat's name. Her ex-boyfriend, Trevor, who says he hasn't seen her. And you know, if you think about it, you know, they talked to him, said it's, you know, they're trying to find her. The next day, when they go to JJ's office because they think he might have something to do with it. And it turns out it's just honeymoon plans. And then she pops up on the phone screen like she's okay. And it's like, okay, something's going on. Then they hack it and find out she's actually being held hostage. Was it a live feed? I don't know. But, Mia and JJ have a conversation where he says they need to take a break. And then she outright tells them that JJ broke up with me. No, he said they needed to take a little break. they need to, it's not right, all right, we're done. He just said, we need a break from each other. But take that any way you want. That's the way you need it, any way you want. But, I will finish that. Anyway, so, I don't remember how, but they find where she's located, and they trace the signal, and they find where she's located to go to rescue her, and it's revealed that it's Trevor, who is the Deathstroke. And I was just like, I'm sitting there, I'm just like, you could have picked anyone, and you picked him. And why is that? Because he comes walking, you can see he's got something behind his. He's like, oh, you have a mask. So do I. He pulls out the Deathstroke mask, and I'm like, that means nothing with this character. Who even is this guy? Trevor? Trevor Holmst. I don't even know his last name. But his name is Trevor, apparently. And I think he blew himself up because there's this thing where they, you know, the Canaries and Green Arrow, and they, because she didn't want to wear the suit at first, which I understand. And now, because the last time she wore the suit, her dad. So she finally wore the suit here. And so they beat up all the bad guys and they get to the roof. Trevor comes up with his lighter in his hand and he lights turns on this gas and he says he's going to light it up. And he's got this weird marking on his hand here. And he lights it on fire, and you see this thing start to light up. They swoom down with the arrow thing, because this green arrow swoom, and you just see the thing explode. You don't see the guy if he's dead. If they pick this up, maybe he'll still be alive. Who knows? But he might have just blown himself up. Fucking dumbass. Who knows? So we have the endings to this episode. Laurel decides to stay in 2040. Bianca is back to doing her socialite stuff. Mia and JJ make up and get back together, of course. And then we have two cliffhanger scenes. One, Mia and William are standing at the Arrow Memorial Statue. You know, Memorial Statue, which we'll properly see in the series finale, but here we see part of it. And they're standing, you know, they're putting flowers or whatever, and they're standing there. And William gets beeped saying that they want to know if he's the Green Arrow. Which he's like, it's 2040, come on. You could be the Green Arrow or something to Mia. And she's only saying anything. And then he's got the hosen, which Felicity gave to him. And then she goes, can I look at it? And he gives it to her. Because she rolls her eyes at first because he has it. He looks on it, and she looks on it, and it's the same symbol that was on Trevor's hand. So I'm assuming he might play into something. Who knows? But they get hit with these sleepy darts, we'll call them. Tranquilizer darts that put them to sleep, and then they take these, you know, masked people take William away. And Mia passes out. That's not the end. Oh, no, that's not the end. It cuts to JJ, and he's like, baby, I didn't think you were going to be home so soon. And he's attacked by another masked person, holds him down. He's got the same ring as Laurel did. It masks his voice. Trevor also mentions as she, but they didn't never answer that. I'm going to wait for the show. And I want you to remember, and puts the ring on his head, and JJ remembers it. Looks like he's struggling. And then he just sort of looks evil. I don't want him to be outright evil. I want him to struggle with it. Like I said, I wanted Mia to struggle with, you know, loving the man that killed her friend in an alternate timeline. But because of this, now maybe they can move away from that, and he can struggle to be a good man or a bad man. Fight between the two. Don't just have him evil outright. Have him struggle. You know, give him some kind of story. Because we didn't get they're all big about, oh, Charlie Barnett plays John Diggle Jr. and he was maybe two episodes this season, three if you count this one, I guess. But yeah, and like I said, You could say that the funeral, like, Nia being at Oliver's funeral could take place after this, but after William disappearing, I don't think she would just take off for a funeral. And what point in the timeline is this? Did they erase her memory on purpose? I don't understand, because I actually forgot about the ring, because in the promo images, they showed Laurel with the ring. And I, okay, because this is going to get her memories back. But then they showed her promo images for the finale, and they showed Mia there. How are they going to explain that now? Because it makes no sense in continuity with this. And this is just out of continuity. But if she was at the funeral, like, because Diana and Laurel don't even mention her being at the funeral, but we see in the promo images she's at the funeral. So I don't know what's going on, but overall thoughts. I thought it was okay. The music that they used was kind of, oh, what are you doing? some of the techno stuff was okay, because techno's always been kind of a fight thing, but like, some of the music choices, like, I didn't get it when Paige said it, and then when I rewatched it, I'm like, oh yeah, this music is terrible. Hopefully I know it's supposed to be future, like, I know Batman Beyond, when they did their stuff, they had this techno soundtrack, but this is not Batman Beyond. It's supposed to be the future, but it doesn't look as futuristic as you think. Maybe because of, you know, budget, but yeah. I thought it was okay. It started kind of meh, and by the end, I'm like, okay, I want to see where this goes. And the CW has a history of passing on certain, like, Supernatural had two backdoor pilots for two different series. One for Bloodlines, which they passed on, and another one for Wayward Sisters, which they also passed on. And it's confusing, because, like, they got a pretty much full schedule for next year. And they've already greenlit the Superman and Lois TV show without even a pilot or backdoor pilot or anything. They just already greenlit it. So, I hope this gets picked up, because we need a suitable replacement for Arrow. And this is basically Arrow 2.0 in the future. And I'm not sexist by any means, but we need, like, at least a couple more male characters. Even if you have Connor and William. Like, we need, William's one thing, but we need one, a straight character as well. You have one that likes guys, one that likes girls, and then you have the female, you know, that likes guys, and you know. But, I don't know. I really hope they pick this up, because it could be like a week from now, we get the, like, right before the finale. Green Arrow and Canaries picked up for, 13-episode season. And from what it sounds like, they might do, if it's picked up, I think maybe it could be like Legends, where it debuts like January-ish, after the seasons come back from the mid-season finales, for like mid-season premieres and stuff, like, then. But, I don't know. But it could work if they pick it up. Hope they do. So, what are your thoughts on the Green Arrow and the Canaries? Let me know in the comments below. Like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. And I think I might do one of these for the series finale. Maybe. We'll see how it goes. Because overall, I want to do like one for the series finale. Just my overview of the whole series and my kind of background with it. So, maybe I'll see you next week. Who knows? I'll see you before then, because I got more reviews to do. But until next time, I'll see you in the next one.